This conference will now be recorded.
Hi Sen, hi all.
Yes, hi.
In today's class, we are going to explore about the exception handling in a Python programming language.
Okay.
Yeah, any classical programming language, there will be any exceptions and errors. We need to handle those errors by using some techniques. Those techniques today we are going to learn. That is required because the flow of execution must be continue instead of getting any error. We need to handle that if any exception comes, we need to handle that exception and we need to continue the flow of execution. At that time, we require exception handling. Yeah, basically, initially, what is the types of error we will get in a programming language? In any programming language, we will get two types of exceptions.
Okay.
Syntax error and runtime error. These two are the errors we will get in any programming language. Yeah, syntax error and runtime error. What is syntax error? Syntax error occurs when a user means the developer or any programmer will give the syntax as wrongly, then it takes as a syntax error.
Okay. Okay.
The syntax error must be handled by the user only, not by the any exception handler not used, because syntax error is a human created error, so that should be handled by the user only.
Absolutely. Okay, so whenever we try to write any syntax, and for example, there is a comma missing, or there is an additional space, or it's written on capital letter instead of small letter. These are syntax error. Am I right?
Yes, that is the syntax error. Here we have the example for syntax error. Here I have missed the syntax for if condition. You can see that.
Okay.
If x equal to 10, here I have missed the semicolon.
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah, here it resulted an in syntax error, invalid syntax at 10.
Correct. Yeah, I can see it.
This is the example.
Syntax error.
Yeah, another example. If you want to see the another example, loops. Loop is another example. You can take that as loops. For I in list, here I have missed also, here also missed, I have missed print, I am missing hello, I am losing, let's relieve it, just print the print, I am taking the just print, here I missed the parenthesis.
Correct. Yeah. Okay.
Let's see the issue. Yeah, syntax error, missing handling print. Print, how to handle print will be every time it should be in brackets.
Okay, and how effective that search in Stack Overflow is? Imagine I stuck somewhere and I am not able to understand the syntax error. How to figure that out?
Stack Overflow will it will forward you to the Stack Overflow how to write the syntax. What is the exact syntax that will provide at the stack overflow?
Okay. Can you please highlight it to me, please?
Yeah, it will go to the Stack Overflow. You can see, you can explore that example. Yeah, here you can. What is the zero divided by error exception? There you will get the all. Explanation about that exceptions.
Clear.
Here we have the syntax error. If you click on that, what is the syntax here we missing?
Absolutely. Okay.
That will forward you to the Google syntax Stack Overflow. There you will find the multiple option. Then you can understand what exactly the error.
Okay.
Yeah. This is the syntax error. The next error is a runtime error.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
runtime error is execution, the flow of execution will terminated due to any programming logic or memory problems or any input issues. These are these type of errors. These type of errors are called runtime errors. The program execution is going on. At that time, some syntax error, some logical program logic or memory problem or input where you are provided, those are wrongly provided, then the program execution will be stopped. Similar type of errors called runtime errors. Yeah, example of runtime errors. You can see that we are divided by zero. Here we are giving divided by zero, 10 divided by zero. It is one type of runtime error. It is program executed. It is not a syntax error here. Zero divided by error. It is showing the error is because of runtime. It is happening at the runtime.
Yeah, correct. Okay.
Yeah, if you want to see another example. Here I am giving the input. I am assigning value to the, converting it to integer, some value, input value.
Okay.
Number you want to convert into the integer, the entered value.
Correct, got it. But that entire value, if it is text,
it will give the issue. Here I am entering the value 10 in words.
Okay.
It given the error, value error. This is the error, runtime error. But because flow is not terminated, flow is terminated because of given input. Input is wrong. I have given the input is wrong.
Correct. I am declaring that input as integer, but I am giving that value as a string. So on that time, it will not accept. That's the error which is coming up. Correct.
Yes.
Cool. So these errors are classified as
runtime errors.
Runtime errors. Okay. So one is syntax, one is runtime error. Okay.
Yeah. These runtime errors should be handled by the exception handlings.
Absolutely clear.
Exception handling techniques used for the runtime errors only. For syntax errors, user must be correct their syntax. Should be know the what is the correct syntax, and he should be correct by the user only. From the runtime errors should be handled by the exception handlings.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Clear.
Runtime errors in a Python programming language, there are system errors, predefined errors, which are already defined in a what type of errors will come in a runtime. Those are defined in these type of errors are system generated errors. You can see that zero divided by error. Type in error. A program you are at any time the zero divided by error will come. Type error. You can where you want to convert the string into an integer. Here is the type error. The value error. Here value we have provided the different value so that it thrown a error value error. End of file not found error, where you are working with the file where the file is not existed, then it written the file not found error. This is a system defined error. System already have these errors, exception errors, end of file error, file is ended error, sleeping error, type punctuated error. These are the some errors already defined in a system logs.
Okay.
Yeah. How we can handle the runtime errors? The syntax of runtime errors handling is try and exception. Except.
Okay.
What is the exception we got here? The exception and handling code. It is a risky code we need to write in a try block.
After try section, whatever code, wherever I predict that there may be error, that would be under try section.
Yes.
And except means if that is not there.
Yes. if the error came, the exception came, then the acceptable block will be executed in that risky code.
Correct.
Acceptable will be called.
If there is no error, then it will continue.
Yes.
As normal.
Yeah.
That's it. So there are two line items is very important. There are other aspects also, as if I know else, we can add few more syntax into error, but those are depth. But as of now, I can say try your error wherever error may occur. Then if error occur, it goes to the accept section, and then whatever handling the code alternative code means, there I will put the alternative, let's say predefined my custom solution to handle that error. Yeah, over to you.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Here we can see the one example where the flow of execution stops due to the exception. Here you can see I have given the statement one, statement two, and I have given one statement with the exception, like divided by error exception. Let's see the execution, how it goes. Yeah. Here you can see the execution is terminated at second line only. Only executed first line. The print statement two is not executed.
Okay.
Here you can see the exception came at second line, so that execution stopped. In order to continue the execution, here in this situation we will use the exception handling.
Correct. Let me understand one more point. Print, you are printing something, you are dividing something, then there again you are printing something. So the second line, there is a problem, there is an error.
Yes.
Okay. Now what you are doing?
The problem is due to that problem, execution is stopped. The statement two is not printed. The flow of execution is stopped here. Mm-hmm. Only statement one is the output.
Correct, because it stopped in the second line. Correct. That is division error.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Got it. Okay. Fine.
In order to execute the statement two, we go for the exception handling. Here you can see that I handled the exception by using try except class.
Yeah. Correct. Okay.
Yeah. Here we got the divided by zero error. Like I will give the another. Yeah. Print. Statement one. Let's use the try. Try. Yeah, we can give the message here. What type of error you will get?
Okay.
In accept.
Okay, so try I understand, accept I understand. Then you are putting a message box, correct?
Yes.
No. Then you are going to finally.
Fine. It is not finally. It is a flow of execution. We are checking the flow of execution is continued or not here by using try.
Got it.
The flow of execution is continued. If instead of we are getting the error, we are passing the control, running control to the next line item. You can see the statement one and statement two is executed successfully.
Okay.
We have used here the technique exception handling, try and accept.
Okay.
Yeah, we can use accept as multiple exception. You can use like that also. Here you can see we accept is multiple blocks. Here you can. Okay. Throw the another exception type error.
Yeah.
These are the exceptions. System defined error. You can say that it is a zero divided by error. Sometimes it can happen the type error also. Here we have used different type here, integer and it is string. At that time it will be a type error. Mm-hmm. It will go to the type error then.
Okay.
It will go to the type error block.
Correct.
If it is a type, you can say type error. It is zero divided because of it is type error exception, so that it go to the type error. If it is a exception zero error, it will go to the zero divided by error.
Okay, so now it is zero divided by error, correct?
Now
it is zero divided.
Yes.
Yeah. And now if you, can you make a type error there?
Type error, if you want to take the type error, you are converting something into the mismatching the types. Here it is an integer, we are creating the string. It is a type error,
yes,
it comes
now
to type
it
error.
Go to type. Awesome. Now it is clarified. So what exactly is happening? It is executing the first stage by default. Then
yes.
There is a vulnerable place where there is a problem may occur. So
yes.
Within try, I have put it that line item where the problem may be. Then what is the probability of that output, of that error? Either it is known or unknown. If it is known, except I am defining those system variable. If it is known,
yes.
If it is unknown, rest of everything would be unknown. Then I will put accordingly, correct?
Yes.
So it is not mandatory to define that zero division error, type error. Imagine I am not defining it. Or
yes,
imagine
sir.
I am not classifying
it. It is not a mandatory. It is not a mandatory. You can give the any code here, like except.
Yeah, correct. So like here we are classifying, which is good, because it is known error. I know what may be probably the error reason. So I'm classifying
yes.
it, which is absolutely fine. Imagine I am not sure and I'm not able to classify. Then how exactly it goes?
Yeah,
on
here,
that time,
here it like this, you can use this.
Yeah, only error.
Only error. No, no. We don't know what error will come.
Got it. But keep that previous example. That example was really good.
Yes.
It's not
for
handling,
for flow of execution. You need to use the finally. You don't know what will become. Here you can see the finally block will executed. The syntax error came.
Syntax error
name
came
error.
In where? In error
yeah,
only.
Name error. Yeah, in error only. Name error. We should give the exact divided by error. Zero divided
okay.
by error.
Okay.
Yeah, here you can see that we have handled the zero divided by error with error, and finally we have printed the final statement also. In order, the finally will execute if the error comes or not, the finally block will always execute.
Correct. Okay. Now it should. Okay. Except zero division error. Got it. So it's clear to me.
Yeah.
Even if I don't define, it will still work, correct? Imagine that, except you are defined that this is system error. Even if you don't define, it will still work and give us the output.
Yes.
Correct. So,
yeah,
okay.
Let's try to use some examples to know as.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Examples.
This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, these are the example we can use extensively in future programming classes. So that finally, what is the conclusion of this class is we have learned about the what are the errors in a classical programming language, syntax error, runtime errors, and how to handle the syntax error and runtime error. Syntax errors only handled by the user. The runtime errors, at that time we will use runtime for the end, and we need to use the exception handlings. Those are the exception handling, how the basic exception handling can be done by using try and except block, and after the try and exception, how the finally block will execute. We have seen this in this class.
Correct. Yes.
That's it.
And furthermore, implementation we will observe. Correct.
Yes.
What
we will
like
go in the future class. future classes we will go any programming we are going to do, we will use the try and exceptions.
Correct. So just add, absolutely, Shini. Definitely, I will request you to integrate error handlers in our sessions, so
yes.
that we know the practical use of it. Okay.
Yes.
And what I have learned personally, the it has first of all the structure and the scenarios where we use it. When we use error handling, it's like whenever we develop a code, either it is a happy, like straightforward process, or it is a wrong, like it may go wrong. That kind of
yes.
steps. On that time, once we predict that, or for our safety or precaution, we put in the error handling to handle in case if any error generated on that section. But as a Python convention, it is a best practice not to give the error across all the blocks. Wherever
yes.
you are seeing the code is vulnerable or risk to get error, we need to put that into error block instead of
yes.
entire code or entire
yes.
chunky block.
In the try block, in the try block.
Correct.
You need to handle the exception in except class.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yes.
And except class also, if you can classify as many as, because if you classify, so there is type error, division error, there are syntax error, other errors are there, correct? It is coming, or let's say type case error, any kind of error is coming. If as much as detail, if you can classify, it would be really great. And there are certain more syntax are there in error handling, like else is also there, if I recall correctly, Shirin.
Yes.
Yeah, else is there, but only one we can use. That's it. Only one time we can use. We can't use multiple times. So there are those things we'll observe. But overall, really, it's great input from beginner understanding point how exactly it works, Shirin. From my end, I'm absolutely clear on this.
Yeah.
Okay. So anything else from your end on exception today?
No, this is enough for the basic handlings, basic programming beginners, how to handle the any exception comes in a programming flow. If you are writing any data science program where you will expect some exceptions, any algorithm, how to handle the basic exceptions. And this will be required. This will be required in any programming language, any programming in Python.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Clear. So okay, we'll connect in the next session. What we can expect in the next session, Chini?
Yeah, from next
what
session we are trying to cover a object oriented programming techniques in a
okay.
Python programming language. How
sure.
we can
so,
how the OOPS concepts are handled in a Python programming language. In a part wise, we will see that. Yeah.
Got it.
What are the object
okay.
inheritance and what are the encapsulations? Technologies and packaging and how the importing and exporting is happening. We can see it in an object oriented programming language. How the Python is using the OOPS
absolutely
concept.
Clear. Clear to me. So sure, we will follow that approach and we will explore and connect in the next session. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Shini, thank you so
okay.
much for your time. We'll connect and catch up in the next session.
Yeah.
Thank you.